Welcome to Rebuild My Church Again, RMCA Bishop Channel. May God bless you for subscribing this channel, and may the Lord reward you with the success and prosperity in everything you do today as you listen to this spiritual message through which God is going to talk to you. In the past, I have heard some people quoting Mahatma Gandhi saying, "I love Christ, but I hate Christians." Then I asked people why such a thing is told about our Mahatma. The answer was that it was because the British, being Christians, should not have done what they did in India. This is what Gandhiji believed. I reserve my comments on this since I am not sufficiently qualified to do so. It may require much more historical studies than what I have done so far. But what is of my interest is that there are many others who also have made such comments to mean that many Christians do not live as Christians. That means there is something very serious that we all need to introspect. Jesus commanded his disciples to love one another as he loved them. This is the fundamental thing about which each one of us should reflect. It is said, one should act according to his conscience. But what we often forget is about the need for the formation of conscience according to the principles of eternal values and universal moral norms. For example, there are terrorists who claim that they are acting according to their conscience. But how can we accept, for example, shooting down of small kids in a school in America or killing of an old priest while celebrating Holy Mass inside a church in France, etc.? On an inquiry, probably the perpetrators of these crimes might also say that they were acting according to the dictates of their conscience. That means it was an erroneous conscience. Therefore, here comes the need for formation of conscience. To give another example, cheating in sports is dishonesty for the whole world, while it seems in Argentina it is considered as the smartness of the player. It is the duty of the referee to catch any fouls if committed. At the same time, you can outsmart the referee, and that is appreciated. The classical example of this is the hand of God goal of Maradona on 22nd June 1986 Football World Cup. Everywhere, cheating is always cheating. So, formation of character is very important. Moral science classes take care of, let us say, character formation, and religious teachings take care of faith formation. There seems to have a disconnect between the faith formation and character formation. Therefore, what people in general ask today is the church doing enough in this field? We do give help to the parents in faith formation and character formation. Only thing is, often this is given separately. Now, we need to combine this and then give, let me propose, Christian character formation, in which faith formation and character formation are combined. This should not end up as one-time activity, like preparation for receiving the Holy Communion. It should be an ongoing formation, not only for the children, but also for the elders. If this is not taken care of, instead only taken for granted, and then get deviated into other subjects like world peace, environment protection, etc., the final result will be creation instead of true Christians, but of some wayward activists who are in surplus supply and that too abundant in circulation. Teachings of Christ are only used by them to support their interest and not used for Christian character formation. Often we get confused with the idea, if someone says the truth, then he is a Christian, and because he is a Christian, he is saying the truth. These are two different things. If this is not understood properly, I believe the dichotomy of faith and life will continue to exist. If we analyze the teachings of Jesus, we will discover that what Jesus did was to give a Christian character formation. Observe what Jesus said, "I have loved you as my heavenly Father has loved you. You love one another as I have loved you. Go and do likewise. Do this in memory of me," etc., etc., etc. In all these, what he says, there is a link between the disciple and Jesus Christ. Thus, an intimate union with Christ becomes the reason and goal of being a true Christian, a person in whom Christ dwells, Christ in. There is a difference in saying, live according to your faith, and living according to faith in Jesus. What we need to preach and practice is the second one, living according to faith in Jesus. Then we will act according to what Jesus said, and we will not do what Jesus has forbidden to do. Thus, Jesus becomes the standard to measure the quality of our life. But often, this does not happen. In that case, public opinion, which is often manipulated by the immoral, prejudiced, and fake media, will become the criterion. Public opinion will become the criterion to decide what the truth is. That leads one to live like all others and not as a true Christian. It is nothing but a crowd mentality. All do, and therefore I too do, is the justification. Here begins the erosion of Christian identity. That's why protecting the Christian identity is often limited to wearing cross or rosary instead of rigorously following a lifestyle which is modeled on the teachings of Christ. For that to happen, our identity as Christians must be drilled into the consciousness from childhood. It should go into our default system. It should become our DNA, which cannot be changed. The holy martyrs in the church are examples of this. They never did anything against their faith. And if forced, they would prefer death instead. That is the result of Christian character formation. Pope Francis meditates on what it means to abide in Jesus' love by giving a practical example of self-giving service to others. He took his cue from the Gospel according to John 15, 9-17. Pope Francis explored the fruit that can be seen when a Christian abides in Jesus' love. The Pope taught that Jesus invites us to abide in his love so that his joy may be in us and our joy may be full. He said this love has its origin in God the Father, who is love and flows like a river through Jesus, his Son, to us. The love Jesus gives us is the same with which the Father loves him, pure, unconditional, and freely given, said the Pope. By giving it to us, Jesus treats us like friends, making us know the Father. and he involves us in his same mission for the life of the world. We remain in Jesus' love, he added, by keeping his commandments. In the same passage, Jesus summarized his commandments with the words, that you love one another as I have loved you. Pope Francis said, loving Christ means going beyond our own selves and opening up to those in greater need. This means to love not in word but in deed. The love of knowing, we are the joy of knowing that we are loved by God despite our infidelities, enables us to face the trials of life confidently, makes us to live through crises so as to emerge from them better. Our being true witnesses consists in giving this joy, because joy is the distinctive sign of a true Christian. Pope Francis noted that loving like Christ requires us to put aside other loves offered by the world, like the love of money, success, and power. My dear friend, let me give you a few cases as examples of this. In 1994, President of Poland, Lech Walesa, said he would resign if Parliament definitively approves a law permitting abortion. Walesa was quoted as telling the Telepache religious station that he would give up the presidency rather than sign an abortion bill. He got this courage to say like that from the Christian character formation he received from his childhood. To give another example, very recently, the president of Malta, Mr. George Vella, who is also a medical doctor, made the comment to NET News on May 17th, 2021, a few days ago. This is what he said: I would rather resign than sign the abortion bill. To the Times of Malta, Mr. George Vella said, I will never sign a bill that involves the authorization of murder. See the impact of Christian formation. Much before all of them, Saint Maria Goretti protected her bodily purity at the cost of her life. This is called living according to faith in Jesus and in his teachings. Therefore, to be faithful to the identity of a true Christian will mean living according to the teachings of Jesus. It is a lifestyle. Becoming a Christian does not consist only in getting a baptism certificate, because that certificate only states that the person is baptized. It does not certify that he has a Christian lifestyle. It may be taken for granted, but in that case, it will be equal to carrying a driving license without even knowing or learning to drive. That certificate will be useful only for official purposes and not for practical purpose of driving. Similarly, our baptism certificate may help in official purposes, like getting privileges of being a Christian. But for the practical purposes, the certificate will not help. For that, as one needs to learn driving to make the driving license relevant and meaningful, so too, we need to have a Christian lifestyle, which is living according to the teachings of Jesus, in order to make our baptism certificate relevant and meaningful. So, my dear friend, let us develop a Christian lifestyle through Christian character formation. And that's how we can rebuild the church again. That's all for the day. My dear friend, share this message with your near and dear ones and discuss some of these points with them afterwards. They may agree or disagree, all the same. This sharing is a spiritual act, and thus you can make God happy and remain yourself blessed by Him. Let us pray. O God, bless RMCA family of our regular listeners. Almighty God, touch them, heal them, liberate them, inspire them, motivate them, guide them, protect them, and bless them. Eternal Father, grant them the humility to be obedient to your commandments, the courage to be witnesses to your beloved Son Jesus, and the worthiness to be filled with the Holy Spirit. Lord Jesus, bless them with the freedom to be faithful to the teachings of the church and to be bold in defending her. O Holy Spirit, transform this listener into a better child of God and a better Christian. Fill him with your love, peace, and happiness in life. Let every RMCA listener be blessed with the intercession of Mary and Joseph. Now, my dear, I give you my apostolic blessing. May Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. It is good to listen to these talks, my dear, one in the morning and one in the evening. Then you see the qualitative difference that comes in your life. Wish you all the good things in life. Yours in the mission of the church, Bishop Franco Mulakel.